Okay, ginseng is grown from seed. It probably could be propagated vegetatively, but the regulations regarding the harvest of ginseng require that the entire root be harvested. So really, the only way ginseng is propagated is through seed. Ginseng plants generally become reproductive when the root attains a certain size. That could be as early as 2 or 3 years into the growth cycle. It might be typically in a forest, it would be closer to 8 to 10 years into a life cycle. In a field situation where it's grown under artificial shade, the plants are almost all reproductive at age 2 and definitely by age 3. But there are some forest sites where ginseng plants may be 20 or 30 or 40 years old and never become reproductive. So it has to do with the root being able to achieve a certain size before it actually starts producing flowers. Typically, when ginseng does produce flowers, the flowers will turn into green berries. The berries are botanically called, I believe they're drupes, and they generally contain two seeds. The dormancy mechanism of ginseng seed is really pretty interesting because most plants that have berries that ripen in the fall of the year, as does ginseng, the berries are bright red, typically those berries will produce seeds that will sprout the following spring, but not ginseng. The seeds that are inside the ginseng berries will not sprout until the spring following the year that they were dropped, or actually 2 years after they were dropped. So it's an 18-month dormancy process.
Two ginseng seed. This one's got a smile, which indicates that the embryo that's within the seed is fully developed. When this seed was harvested, when it was this big, came out of the berry, it was about that big, and the embryo had not fully developed. That embryo was probably 0.02 millimeters. Well, by the time that this seed is going to germinate, 18 months later, that embryo will have grown from 0.02 millimeters to as much as 0.2 millimeters. So there's an embryo inside this seed, a little baby plant, that continues to grow after this berry ripens. And it'll be 18 months before you actually get that smile or that crack on that seed there.
So 18-month cycle from berry to the seeds actually sprouting. The first year ginseng plant is a little tiny, weak little plant. It looks like a strawberry leaf, and that's about as big as it gets for the entire first season. And if it's had a good season and it's grown well, it'll produce an apical bud, which will contain the entire plant for the second season. The second year, it may produce one small strawberry leaf, or it may produce two leaves. Again, this would be in a woodland situation. And generally in the woods, by the third or the fourth year, it'll start to produce a plant that's got three or four compound leaves. And again, if the conditions are right, if it's a good site, by the fifth, sixth, or seventh year, that plant will indeed start to flower and produce seeds. It does not reproduce particularly well on its own. Ginseng berries that ripen in nature and fall to the ground have about a 2 or 3% chance of actually growing into plants. If you take the time to pick those berries and very carefully plant them when they're ripe, you can get that germination rate up to about 85%. But this particular plant that's inside this cage, which I'm going to remove, is really very special. Obviously, it's in the fall, so the plant has already begun to senesce, which means that the leaves have fallen off the plant.
So there's
It's
that.
being protected because critters such as mice or squirrels or turkeys would come and eat the seeds. In this case, we've collected the berries off this plant, and they've been carefully segregated, and they will be replanted to continue this genetic line of wild ginseng. And the reason this is so important is because it represents a strain of wild ginseng that is really unique in the world. This is Catskill Mountain wild ginseng, which is considered the most valuable ginseng in North America. And the reason for that is because of the size and the shape of the roots. I've just unearthed a white bud. That apical bud there contains next year's top. As a matter of fact, the entire top for next year, including the flower stalk, is contained inside this white bud, which you can see here. If you dissected that, much like a tulip bulb, you would see a little miniature plant in there, tightly coiled up with a flower bud on it. And that is the bud will open up next spring in May, and the top will grow out of it. So as long as that white bud is healthy and happy and intact, pretty good chance that that root is going to come up next year. But as I carefully expose some of this soil, we'll see that this root, which is growing from this rhizome, is growing uphill. So there's the second bud right there for the second top that was coming off this plant. This particular root, if I were to dig it up and dry it, it would sell for, it could sell for as much as several thousand dollars for that one root, just because it is a really, really large, really unique wild ginseng root. And I can see here as I'm exposing away portions of the root, just how big that is. This root will remain in the ground so that we can collect the seeds and try to preserve the genetic strain that produces this particular type of ginseng root, which, as I said, is considered the most valuable in the world. So that's a gem, and that's certainly worth putting a cage around. I mean, you could dig that root and sell it for $1,000, maybe $2,000, but then you've lost the genetics for that particular plant. I would estimate it's probably between 10 and 20 years old now, which is about the maximum growth rate for a ginseng during that period of time. After age 20, ginseng, like people, tend to shrink. And as it gets into its middle age and its senior citizen of the ginseng root, it will indeed shrink. And eventually it'll die. You know, it's not immortal. So at some point that root won't be there, but I'm hoping that at least for the next 8, 10, 12 years, or we've got a 20-year lease on this property, I'm hoping that that root will remain there and provide us with 50 or 60 seeds every year.